A reading from the Gospel of John. John chapter 19, verses 17 through 30. Carrying his own cross, Jesus went out to the place of the skull, which in Aramaic is called Golgotha. Here they crucified him, and with two others, one on each side, and Jesus in the middle. Pilate had a note prepared and fastened to the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." Many of the Jews read this sign, for the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and the sign was written in Aramaic, Latin, and Greek. The chief priests of the Jews protested to Pilate, "Do not write the King of the Jews, but that this man claimed to be the King of the Jews." Pilate answered, "What I have written, I have written." When the soldiers crucified Jesus, they took his clothes, dividing them into four shares, one for each of them, with the undergarment remaining. This garment was seamless, woven in one piece from top to bottom. "Let's not tear it," they said to one another. "Let's decide by lot who will get it." This happened that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said, "They divided my garments among them and cast lots for my clothing." So this is what the soldiers did. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time on, this disciple took her into his home. Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of the hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. The quartet will sing Beneath the Cross of Jesus.
Thank you. A reading from Psalm 2, which describes how the people of this world naturally fight against God, but the ultimate victory belongs to our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers gather together against the Lord and against his anointed one. Why do the nations conspire and the peoples plot in vain? The kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers gather together against the Lord and against his anointed one. Let us break their chains, they say, and throw off their fetters. The one enthroned in heaven laughs. The Lord scoffs at them. Then he rebukes them in his anger and terrifies them in his wrath, saying, I have installed my king on Zion, my holy hill. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. He said to me, you are my son. Today I have become your father. Ask of me, and I will make the nations your inheritance, the ends of the earth your possession. You will rule them with an iron scepter. You will dash them to pieces like pottery. Therefore, you kings, be wise. Be warned, you rulers of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry and you be destroyed in your way, for his wrath can flare up in a moment.
Blessed are all who take refuge in him.
The kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers gather together against the Lord and against his anointed one. We sing our next hymn, Stricken, Smitten, and Afflicted.
My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me? I am a worm and not a man, scorned by men and despised by the people. All who see me mock me. They hurl insults, shaking their heads. He trusts in the Lord. Let the Lord rescue him. Let him deliver him. Since he delights in him. My strength is dried up, and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth.
You lay me in the dust of death.
A band of evil men has encircled me.
They have pierced my hands and my feet.
They divide my garments among them,
and cast lots for my clothing.
But you, O Lord, be not far off. Oh, my strength, come quickly to help me. The ensemble will now sing Mighty Cross.
Set me free. It will never lose. we turn to Psalm 27. Although surrounded by darkness and in agony, the son expresses confidence that the Lord will help him. False witnesses rise up against me, breathing out violence. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? That when evil men advance against me to devour my flesh, when my enemies and my foes attack me, they will stumble and fall. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then will I be confident. One thing I ask of the Lord, this is what I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his tabernacle and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At his tabernacle will I sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Hear my voice when I call, O Lord. Be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says of you, seek his face. Your face, Lord, I will seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my helper. Do not reject me or forsake me, O God, my Savior. Though my father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, O Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of my oppressors. Do not turn me over to the desires of my foes. For false witnesses rise up against me, breathing out violence. I am still confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. False witnesses rise up against me, breathing out violence. The solo will continue, be next, the Magnificat.
Done great things.
The service of darkness. God calls his people to repentance from their sin and calls them away from their unbelief to faith. Christians should hear the words as a strong call to repentance addressed to us in our own time. A reading from the Lamentations of Jeremiah the prophet, Lamentations 1, 1 to 5. How deserted lies the city once so full of people. How like a widow is she, who once was great among the nations. She who was queen among the provinces has now become a slave. Bitterly she weeps at night. Tears are upon her cheeks. Upon all her lovers, there is none to comfort her. All her friends have betrayed her. They have become her enemies. After affliction and harsh labor, Judah has gone into exile. She dwells among the nations. She finds no resting place. All who pursue her have overtaken her in the midst of her distress. The roads to Zion mourn, for no one comes to her appointed feasts. All her gateways are desolate. Her priests groan. Her maidens grieve. And she is in bitter anguish. Her foes have become her masters. Her enemies are at ease. The Lord has brought her grief because of her many sins. Her children have gone into exile, captive before the foe. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God.
Thank you.
reading from the Lamentations of Jeremiah, the prophet. All the splendor has departed from the daughter of Zion. Her princes are like deer that find no pasture. In weakness, they have fled before the pursuer. In the days of her affliction and wandering, Jerusalem remembers all the treasures that were hers in days of old. When her people fell into enemy hands, there was no one to help her. Her enemies looked at her and laughed at her destruction. Jerusalem had sinned greatly and so has become unclean. All who honored her despise her nakedness. She herself groans and turns away. Her filthiness clung to her skirts. She did not consider her future. Her fall was astounding. There was none to comfort her. Look, O Lord, on my affliction, for the enemy has triumphed. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God.
Reading from the Lamentations of Jeremiah the prophet, Lamentations 1, 10 through 14. The enemy laid hands on all her treasures. She saw pagan nations enter her sanctuary, those you had forbidden to enter your assembly. All her people groan as they search for bread. They barter their treasures for food to keep themselves alive. Look, O Lord, and consider, for I am despised. Is it nothing to you, all you who pass by? Look around and see. Is any suffering like my suffering that was inflicted on me, that the Lord brought on me in the day of his fierce anger? From on high he sent fire, sent it down into my bones. He spread a net for my feet and turned me back. He made me desolate, faint all the day long. My sins have been bound into a yoke. By his hands they were woven together. They have come upon my neck, and the Lord has sapped my strength. He has handed me over to those I cannot withstand. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God.
Thank you.
Christ became obedient for us unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has exalted him to the highest place and given him the name that is above every name. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. God most holy, look with mercy on this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed, be given over into the hands of the wicked, and suffer death upon the cross. Keep us always faithful to him, our only Savior, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The ensemble will sing Up on Calvary.
Calvary, my Lord died for me, and he bled to set me free. He gave his life away on the true prophetic day. He knew it couldn't be any other way. Like a sheep, he was led slain without a sound or complaint, and every time his blood hit the ground, made a river of love that swept my sins away. They robed him with the shame, crowned him with the pain, and they mocked his holy name. On Golgotha's hill, where criminals they killed, he hung there just to do the Father's will. On the forgive us. Father, forgive me, for I know what I do. Set me free. Your angels come to Abram's bosom, bear me home, that I may die unfearing, and in its narrow chamber keep my body safe in peaceful sleep until your reappearing, and then from death awaken me, that my own eyes with joy may